that our heart and such that our action become more a reflection of you. Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated. I took privilege this morning and changed the gospel reading. I do apologize. Good morning, friends.
Good morning.
I am glad to be here with you on the second Sunday of Lent. Together during this special time, we are all making a pilgrimage toward the cross, a place where Jesus laid bare and offered his visible body so that we might experience a life more abundant, a place where we are about to learn the limitations of death and the power and breath of God's light, God's mercy, God's grace, and God's love for us. Now, as you know, we are letting go and picking up things along the way. And we are trusting that this exercise will help to deepen our experience at the cross once we arrive. In our gospel reading today, we hear the story of a mountain experience between a leader and his followers, Jesus and the usual suspects, Peter, James, and John. The experience as presented in Mark is about 7 verses. The story is fast moving. They went up, they came down. In between, Jesus' appearance changed. Elijah and Moses suddenly appear. God speaks. The disciples are afraid. Friends, it is a fast moving story. So much so, if you blink, you may read right over and through it without giving it a moment of pause and deliberate attention. I believe that one of the important observations in this story is in regard to intimacy with Jesus. Friends, I do not think that you can experience intimacy, closeness with Jesus, and be the same afterward. Throughout the gospel, we are witnesses to a group of men and women who are invited to live their lives with Jesus. This is no accident. Within the first 20 verses in the Gospel of Mark, we are introduced to the disciples. There are a total of 678 verses in Mark. So 3% into this rendition of Jesus' life, we learn about the people who we would later call friends. Like most of us, Jesus wanted a few persons close to him. Like most of us, Jesus wanted to share important moments of his life with them. He wanted to pray with them. He wanted to eat with them. He wanted to fish with them. He wanted to wail against the political structures of oppression with them. He wanted to change with them. He wanted to be with them. This sentiment, this desire expressed by Jesus, sometimes got a negative reaction from his friends. For example, when Peter heard Jesus tell people about his death and how he would die, Peter rebuked him. "No, you will not die, so stop saying so." You know, as a child hearing these stories about Jesus, I would often imagine myself in the story. I would imagine my own reaction to Jesus. For example, I know for certain, had I been on the mountaintop with Jesus that day, I would have peed my pants. I would have been afraid, just as the disciples. Even now, I Still, I'm in awe just hearing the story about Jesus' bright light and about his ability to transform from darkness to light. I am a range of emotions when I hear stories about Jesus' life. This imagination to be with Jesus often leads to a bit of jealousy, I will confess. I sometimes envy the disciples' closeness to Jesus. I still do. These men, these women, and children had the opportunity to touch the hem of his garment. They had the opportunity, even though we don't see it in scripture, to give him a high five. These men, women, and children were firsthand witnesses to the paradigm shift of life that Jesus presented to them in the Sermon on the Mount. I envy them because I know that their lives were not the same after their encounter with Jesus. They were healed and they were fed. The woman at the well was liberated and restored. They were seen. They were empowered to see themselves as fully human and as fully divine. Just when I cannot stand myself and my envy much longer, I am reminded of some good news. The good news is this. Jesus called those faithful men and women to not just live in the good news of God, but to share the good news of God. In other words, their intimacy, their closeness to Jesus is an intimacy and closeness that I am invited to. It is an intimacy and closeness that you are invited into. Therefore, like the disciples, we too are transformed. We are healed. We are fed. We are liberated and restored. We are seen. We are empowered to see ourselves as fully human and fully divine. Friends, the mountain experience is an important reminder that through our intimacy, our closeness with Jesus, our life story is one of transformation. We are being called to transformation, not just for the sake of it, but for the sake of being in right relationship with God, for being in right relationship with ourselves, and for being in right relationship with one another. Today, I remind you that we are forever invited into this intimacy with Jesus. We are called to share this intimacy with others. Let us pray. Gracious God, all wisdom tell us that where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. And that all of us are being transformed into the same image from one degree of glory to another. Thank you for your invitation to be transformed. On the mountaintop that day with his friends, Jesus demonstrated that essential to living in you is change. The kind of change and transformation that draws closer to you and closer to one another. Our Savior, Jesus, came to us, and he remains with us, so that through our relationship, we are reminded of who and whose we are. So this day we give thanks for this gift of intimacy, a gift through which we are transformed into your merciful into your gracious and into your loving grace.